Hi everyone. Today I'm going to walk you guys through the framework AutoGen, which is a multi-agent framework, and we're going to talk a little bit about how you can use it to set up multi-agent workflows, as well as how you can set it up to be traced and evaluated within Phoenix and Arise. So let's dive in. And so for anyone who hasn't heard of AutoGen before, it's what's called a multi-agent framework. And so what that means is it's built around defining multiple different agents, each with their own individual prompts and maybe tools and roles, and then defining how those agents are going to work together in some way to get to an eventual answer or response back to your user. So there's a few different ways you can set up how these agents will work together. There's things like a free joint chat where they can each speak to each other. There's more of a hierarchical chat you can use where each one of them speaks back to a single kind of supervisor. And then there's a few other patterns as well that we'll look at as we keep going here. So let's check out a couple of quick examples before we jump into some more code. So the basic version of kind of two agent exchange here is where you have two agents that are talking back and forth to each other. So if you look at the code on the left, we're using these conversable agents. This is an object within the AutoGen framework where we have a student and a teacher. Each one has its own kind of configuration and its own system prompt here. And the idea is we can essentially pass in a question that we might have, and then the student agent will pose it to the teacher agent. In this case, what is a triangle inequality? And then those two agents will go back and forth talking to each other until either a max number of cycles has been hit or some sort of termination trigger has been tripped. So in this case, we've defined max turns to be two. So they'll just speak back and forth to each other for two rounds. And then we're actually going to summarize the results and give them back to the user. So this basically allows your agents to go back and forth. Maybe the student agent will have follow-up questions to the teacher to get more information. They'll continue going back and forth for two rounds and then get a response back to the user. Those are a very basic kind of setup within AutoGen, but still super powerful. As you get to more complicated setups, this is where you have things like a sequential chat, where you define how different groups of agents will talk to each other and then move the result of their conversation over to a next set of agents. And so this is one other approach that AutoGen offers for more kind of pipelines in a way. And then they also have an approach, it's called a group chat, where you have multiple different agents that all might want to work together to get to a solution, and you use what's called a group chat manager to decide which agent is going to speak at any given time. So the way this works is you define multiple different agents as well as a group chat manager, and then at each turn the group chat manager will select one of the agents to speak. That agent will speak and generate a response that goes back to the group chat manager, who broadcasts it out to the other agents, and then it selects the next speaker, and you continue in that way either for a max number of turns or until you hit to some sort of termination clause. So we have a very basic example on the left here where we've defined different individual agents that can do one mathematical operation here, and those are combined into a group chat with a max rounds of interaction. And then we also create a group chat manager that's connected to that group chat, again has its own config and everything along those lines. And then we actually can launch that group chat itself with a question. The group chat manager will select from each agent who should speak at any given moment and continue going through that whole cycle we talked about until they get to a response. So this is your more interesting, kind of powerful example here. Let's look at a couple different code examples in real life. So first, let's look at an example of a two-agent back-and-forth chat, and kind of a real-world example of that first pattern we looked at in the slides. This notebook is on our Phoenix GitHub repository, and we'll link it in the link in the description below. So we're doing some initial installing of packages here. We're adding some API keys. I'm going to skip through this, and you guys can go take a look deeper if you want to see how we do that. And then we are installing some other packages we might need. And then we're actually instrumenting this with Phoenix as well. So this is where we're going to add some tracing. It's not 100% necessary to do to make AutoGen work, but it gives us much more visibility into what's happening, which can be super useful for these multi-agent turns that go back and forth multiple times. So in this case, we're basically just launching a local version of Phoenix, and then we're connecting to that with this register call. And because we're using OpenAI as our instrumenter, as our underlying model, we're instrumenting OpenAI here. So now with that, we're going to get visibility on whatever we do with AutoGen. And so from here, now we can define our AutoGen code. So I mentioned we're going to have two agents. So we're going to have an assistant agent here that has basically going to act as our kind of general LLM that can respond back to user queries. So we're defining this assistant agent, and then we're defining what's called a user proxy agent. And the user proxy agent is something that comes with AutoGen. It's a pre-built object within AutoGen, and it acts as the user as they go through and prompt, in this case, our assistant agent. So it's that specific type of user proxy. And so when it gets an input, it will kind of go back and forth with the agent in kind of a similar way to our student and teacher. In this case, it's going to represent the user, and it's going to go back and forth until it gets to an answer. So there's a couple other things to call out here that are interesting. One is that we're using this termination message here. Instead of having a max turns, we're just saying once you see the word terminate at the end of a message, that's how we know we're done, and we can use that to kind of signal the end of the execution. And then something that's very cool is that we're also adding a code execution config. What this will do is it will allow our user proxy agent to actually execute code that it generates. You can usually group that into a Docker container so it's kept safe in that way, but it allows your agent to have even more kind of powerful execution here. And so when we run that, here's what we get. We're adding in this question of what date is today, compare the year-to-date gain for Meta and Tesla stocks. And so you'll see our agent go through. Our user proxy agent is gonna first give a response to the question there to our assistant. Our assistant is going to outline its path here and then try to generate some code. The user proxy will try to execute that code, but actually runs into an error here. And then here's the nice thing about the user proxy is that it takes that error and it's actually going to try to correct the code and try to make it more runnable. So it first tries to correct the code here, still fails in that case, and then it's going to try again. And in this case, it is actually going to succeed in executing the code. And so now it gets to this particular response back that we have for that execution. And so we finally get our answer back to the user there, and you can see that result. So one of the nice things is the user proxy agent can not only execute code, but also kind of debug code live as you go through. And so now if we want to see what this looks like in Phoenix, we can see the kind of chat completion call that is attached to this execution flow here. So in this case, we've got our system prompt that's being used with our particular agent. And so you can see the full system prompt that's being used there. And then we get our user proxy question, which is what date is today? Compare the year-to-date gain for Meta and Tesla. You see our agent is executing or is coming up with some of that code. You can see the response that it gets to here as it generates some of that code. And then our user proxy tries to execute that code. In this case, it actually fails to do so. And so now it's gonna try to regenerate some of the code with the assistant. And so you can see it going through that flow here. Gonna try to execute again. I think it fails again in that case. And so we're gonna go try to generate the code one more time. This time the code actually worked. And so now we get to the output from that code. And the final step is that assistant taking the output, generating response from it. So we get the full visibility in Phoenix that makes it a little easier to debug. And then we can take this data and we can actually go use that to evaluate the performance of this. We could attach labels, we could do whatever we wanted to from there within Phoenix and Arise. Hopefully this gave you a good picture of the AutoGen framework, how it can be used, and some of the benefits that come with the multi-agent approach. There's a lot of power in this approach, and if you set it up well, then you can create some really cool applications. If you have any questions about Phoenix, Arise, or AutoGen, just curious about wanting to discuss more on multi-agent frameworks, come join our community Slack on our website. There's some great discussions that we've had in there debating the pros and cons of these different approaches. So we hope to see you there soon, and happy building. Take care.